Hey there, I'm so glad that you're here. So as you might already know, AnyCubic recently announced their all new Kobra 3 combo, a high speed 3D printer that comes paired with a filament dryer that prints multicolor. And in this video, we're going to take a first look at it, try out some multicolor prints, and see what sets this setup apart from the other offerings coming out on the market. Let's get after it. Just to get the disclaimers and stuff out of the way, AnyCubic did send this printer and some of their new Pantone filament over free of charge, and because I am trying to do more projects and fewer reviews, they also did agree to sponsor this video. So this definitely isn't a review, but all opinions are still my own, and I wouldn't say anything that I don't feel to be true. Getting this thing unboxed and set up was relatively easy. Because of the AnyCubic Color Engine or ACE Pro taking up so much space in the box, it actually doesn't ship flat like other bed slingers, but there are still a bunch of things that you do need to put on, like the tool head, the filament flinger thing, the Bowden tubes, and all of that. Now, I'll be honest, when I initially unboxed this printer, I was a little disappointed. It felt to me like a really derivative machine, so similar to some of the other machines that have been rolling out on the market. Honestly, I was kind of like, come on, AnyCubic, you guys are a huge company. Can't you do something a little more innovative? But as I spent more time with this machine, I printed out more and more challenging models, and as I've seen what it's capable of, it's actually really grown on me. And not just because they're paying me. Let me show you why. So the first thing I printed on this guy was, of course, the 3D Benchy. I am, after all, a law-abiding citizen, and I was actually completely shocked to see an 11-minute, 30-second Benchy on the machine's memory from the factory. But believe it or not, it is, in fact, an 11-minute and 30-second Benchy, which even seems to follow speedboat rules. In fact, I think it might even use 15% infill instead of 10%. Now, as you can see, the cooling on this machine is lacking for such high-speed printing of such incredibly small parts, but honestly, this isn't a realistic test. You would probably never print something so small so fast, and if you needed to, you would just slow down for this type of bridging if you weren't specifically trying to get under a certain number. And I suspect that AnyCubic was very deliberately trying to get under 12 minutes. The reason that I share that this thing is technically capable of a 12-minute Benchy is just to demonstrate how incredibly fast this thing moves, right up there with the other fastest printers on the market right now. I don't really like to share top speed numbers like 600 millimeters per second and 40,000 millimeters per second acceleration, because those are theoretical limits, but to show that it actually can print and move that fast is pretty cool, even if the cooling is lacking. With the obligatory Benchy out of the way, I wanted to test the kind of headline feature of this printer, and that is multicolor printing. I should note that for the first few days of my testing, I didn't actually have any way to slice my own print files because AnyCubic is still working on a Mac version of their slicer, but fortunately, I got some of my friends to slice stuff for me, and I was pretty quickly off to the races. I did decide to print a bunch of these cute little sea turtles.
I like turtles.
And here I used actually another one of those Pantone filaments that AnyCubic provided for the green part of the turtle. But as you'll probably notice, either myself or my colleague Sergey, who was helping me test out this machine, accidentally swapped the different browns when we were mapping the filament on the screen to what was sliced because someone else had sliced it for us. Still, I have to say that these turtles look absolutely gorgeous, despite the incredible difficulty of printing all these little scales spanning many different layers along the arms. This is not a simple print, and it has a ton of filament changes that requires quite a bit of precision. And I kind of love these little dudes, they're awesome.
I like turtles.
From there, I wanted to really push the limits of what this printer could do when it comes to multicolor. So I tried printing something with a lot more filament changes that would take quite a lot more time. See, I still didn't have the ability to actually slice any files myself. That would come later. But my friend Elsa did slice this model of Skye from Paw Patrol for, you guessed it, my 3.5-year-old son. Which is why, by the way, it came out a whole lot bigger than I actually wanted. I decided to print it anyway. In any case, this did give me an opportunity to really try out and test a few different things on this printer. You can see here that some of the tree supports did actually detach because I hadn't yet learned how to manually override the Z offset, and they are still dialing in their new LevyQ 3.0 automatic bed leveling. So some of my tree supports did detach. I later figured out that there is a way to override the Z offset and correct it. But still, I honestly think that this thing turned out absolutely awesome, especially in this very vibrant Polymaker magenta. It is a little bit nightmare fuel-ish with the pink and brown eyes, so maybe in the future I will upgrade and get another one of these Ace Pro units, which is like $289, because you can actually link two of them together for 8-color printing if you want. In fact, AnyCubic has actually built the filament buffer directly into the Ace unit, which is going to then allow them to roll out support for many of their other older printers, allowing you to add multicolor to existing printers. And they're actually even looking into adding Ace support for non-AnyCubic printers, which I think is gonna be a game changer for those of you who don't wanna throw or sell your old printers away, but want to add multicolor to them. Oh, and by the way, to whoever designed this model, they didn't think to make it actually stand up when you fully assemble it. So it looks like Skye is lifting her back leg to pee, even though she's a girl dog. I just thought that was a little bit funny. Either way, this is yet another gorgeous multicolor model, despite the few failed tree supports. And it also gave me the chance to test some of the smart features of this printer. So I hooked up a camera because, unlike the launch bundle that AnyCubic is offering right now, my review unit didn't come with one, and I wanted to be able to monitor my prints remotely through the same AnyCubic app that I actually use with their resin printers, and that worked great. Also, I did get to test the filament runout and jam detection because the white filament first jammed on the roll a bunch and then ran out on a day that I wasn't actually going to come into the office. So actually, all in all, this print took something like 30 plus hours with 17 hours lost of just waiting for me to come back. And it still stayed attached to the bed and it resumed flawlessly with no issues. I actually can't even tell where the pause was, which is pretty impressive. Honestly, this is a beautiful print besides the couple little tree support failures. It's a real shame my son's gonna break it in like 5 minutes. Up next, I wanted to try something that I've actually never done before. See, as you might know if you've been subscribed to the channel for a while, hint, hint, PETG and I have a hate-hate relationship. I live in a climate where, as you can see, humidity is about 75% year-round, and that means that a roll of PETG can get completely waterlogged on even a short print. I'm also not super great about changing out the desiccant on my other multi-material systems. So needless to say, I've never even tried multicolor printing with PETG before, just because how would I? And that's where the Kobra 3 combo really shines. You see, this unassuming multicolor unit, the Ace Pro, is actually a full-fledged filament dryer, allowing you to dry 4 rolls of filament either while the printer is stationary or while printing. And this might not sound like a big deal, but keep in mind that AnyCubic is currently offering this Kobra 3 combo for an early bird price of just $449, which is a full $100 less than the printer combo it most resembles. And then consider the fact that the Sunlu S4 filament dryer, the only one on the market that can dry 4 rolls of filament at once, is an extra $159 on top of that. Now, all of a sudden, this printer combo starts to look like a really, really attractive one for the price. Anyways, I loaded up some of my favorite Sliceworks Ocean CN PETG, and I started drying the filament in anticipation of printing. Unfortunately, the creator of this 3MF had turned on ironing, so my first attempt actually peeled off the bed while it was trying to iron. Ironing has honestly never really worked well for me. And I did also forget to change the white filament to PETG, so it was not printing at the right temperature. So yeah, that failed. But my second print turned out really, really nicely. It still did have a little bit of bed adhesion issues on the drafty open air of my studio, and that might have had to do with the fact that I still hadn't yet figured out how to perfectly adjust the Z offset. But next time, I think I might just use some Magigoo or a brim to keep things planted. But hey, all in all, I'd say that that is a pretty good multicolor PETG print, and if I were to just deal with the bed adhesion, I might print it again and it would come out perfect. So at this point, I was on a roll. AnyCubic had since sent me over their very, very early pre-release profiles for Orca Slicer, which, by the way, they are planning to add full support for both Orca Slicer and Prusa Slicer, including the ability to print directly from the slicer in case you don't want to use their proprietary slicer. So now that I had those preliminary profiles, I was actually able to slice my own files. I still didn't have profiles for other materials like TPU, ASA, or anything like that. Those are going to come later. But I did get to wondering, would I be able to print a large flat ASA part on this open format printer? So to test it out and to take advantage of this pretty large 260 by 260 build volume, I created my own profiles and then I loaded some of this gorgeous Polymaker Polylight ASA for both the white and the red, and I hit print. Strangely, the printer knew that it was supposed to print at 260 and 100, but it still tried to print at 220 and 60. I think that's probably because I'm using hacked together profiles for both the printer and the filament, and I'm positive that that is something that they're going to fix before the printer actually ships to users. Anyways, I just manually bumped up the values once the print had actually started, and the first print kind of detached a little bit and got stuck on the print head. But then I threw some Magigoo at it. Fun fact, did you know that Magigoo's PC version also works perfectly for ASA? And hey, wouldn't you know it? The print just worked. No curling at the edges, no issues changing filament colors, and when the print was cooling down, I actually heard it across the studio making this lovely snap, crackle, popping sound, and it released all by itself. The end result is okay. The print is clean itself, but as you can see, I did some tinkering around with the profiles because they, as I said, aren't quite ready for Orca Slicer yet, and I tried to be very clever and actually set it to do only one perimeter on the top layer, which resulted in this weird kind of outline and not covering all the way on the finer text. But honestly, I'm still thrilled that this open machine combined with a good bed adhesion solution like Magigoo can actually print ASA right out of the box. Get it? Out of the box? Because there's no enclosure? I'm sorry. So this has been just a quick first look at the AnyCubic Kobra 3 combo. Again, this is a sponsored video, not a review, but I can honestly say that even though the software, the firmware, and the third-party slicer profiles are far from ready, I've been pretty impressed with this printer despite my initial skepticism, and I wouldn't have agreed to do this video if I didn't like it. Ultimately, for the $449 early bird price, which includes the Ace Pro, a kilo of Pantone filament, and an integrated camera, it's probably the best value for a mid-sized multicolor printer right now. And as long as you don't mind the proprietary firmware, I really don't think that you'll be disappointed with this at all. So if you do choose to pick one up, do feel free to use my link in the description, which does support the channel a little bit, and it also lets AnyCubic know that they should continue working with me and sending me over cool products that I can then share with all of you. Let me also take a moment to thank our YouTube members and Patreon supporters, particularly our Nylon and Peak members, Chip Cox, Two Crazy Kiddos, Amir Chen, Chris Miller, and Aaron Pape. You guys rock. That's all for this week, but I'll see all of you on the next layer.